Chapter 11. as he loved us, is to encourage the readers in their trials and tribulations. Therefore, he concludes chapter 12. Since we are surrounded with such a huge crowd of witnesses, let us throw off everything that slows us down. Let us fix our gaze on Christ. Let us not grow weary. We are surrounded by so many witnesses, including ourselves. There is something encouraging. There is something inspiring. Something more by the fact that we are surrounded by the power of witnesses. They inspire us, they support us, they encourage us, they journey with us. But there is also something unnerving. There is something terrifying about the fact that we are surrounded. Can we say we are surrounded? Something about the lives of people like Marcellus and Felicitas terrifies us. There is something about their lives that does not stop pounding deep within us, that does not let us sleep, does not let us rest. They threaten us with resurrection. They threaten us with life. Those of you who might be familiar with the works of Julian Swivel, the Baptonal descent, I recognize here that I'm drawing from her poem, threatened with resurrection. Threatened with resurrection. She writes about the massacres in the 1950s of so many farmlands of indigenous people in Guatemala, about the pain and about the memory of those who have been slain, keep the living from sleeping. She writes, it's not the noise in the streets that keeps us from resting, nor is it the shouts of the young people coming up to cry for the disembowing. There is something within us which does not let us sleep, which does not let us rest, which does not stop pounding deep inside. What keeps us from sleep is that they have threatened us with resurrection. They have threatened us with resurrection. Very, very powerful poem. But I draw attention to this poem for two reasons. Christians like ourselves have vowed to serve Jesus Christ, the everlasting King. Because in the poem, it is not only the generals who threatened us with the resurrection, who threatened our lives, the dead, those test our convictions about the resurrection. They test our willingness to be brought into life and life than the one we are now. On the other hand, fear the innocent victims of the killers. Those who have died for love, justice, and peace. Though they are our friends, we fear them. Because they call us to follow them with the marathon of hope. If we are to tell them all we see us, it means that we ourselves have to undergo some form of dying. So we are caught between the killers, those who are killed, between the generals. Marcellus. Right to Thank you.
sounds